On the auspicious occasion of the celebrations relating to the birth anniversary of the Mahatma, I extend my greetings to all Indian nationals, members of the Indian diaspora, and the larger Canadian community. And my felicitations to the Gujarat Cultural Association for a very beautiful and very melodious rendering of the Mahatma's bhajans, as also the presentation by the Mughal Hindi School, which almost stole my speech. Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation, the apostle of peace and non-violence, whose political thought changed the course of our history. Recently, we celebrated the 65th anniversary of our independence, and it is said that in the age of empires, freedom was never given, it had to be taken. And the Indian freedom was won by a generation of giants, but led by a very diminutive figure, but a mighty man whose teachings have such universality, and they are of such time-tested character, particularly in the present times when we see a steep increase in the resurgence in violence and extremism and in terrorism, that India can no longer claim the Mahatma, or India can no longer lay a sole claim to the Mahatma. The Mahatma now belongs to the world. And in recognition of his international persona, the birthday of the Mahatma, October 2, is now being celebrated the world over as the International Day of Nonviolence. And this is the collective decision of the Committee of Nations. And in fact, in the United Nations in 2007, on the floor of the United Nations General Assembly, a resolution was passed to declare October 2 as the International Day of Nonviolence, and this resolution was mooted by the Government of India. And this resolution was passed unanimously by all the member states of the United Nations, and in the passing of this resolution, every Indian diplomat at home or abroad had a major role to play. And it is in this spirit that the High Commission has been taking the initiatives to commemorate the life and works of the Mahatma by installing statues in different cities of Canada, including in Ottawa, which we did last year outside this building near the India Centre. And no sooner had we installed the statue than it was vandalized. The spectacles of the Mahatma went missing. In fact, the spectacles had come to symbolize the Mahatma. All we had to do was draw the picture of the spectacles, and we instantly knew it was the Mahatma. In fact, the spectacle was the delight of every cartoonist in India. But philosophically speaking, did the Mahatma need spectacles? Was the Mahatma lagging in foresight? Certainly not. Otherwise, how could he have foreseen the demise of imperialism and colonialism a full half a century before it actually happened in India, and it triggered a domino effect in the rest of the world? Or was he lacking in nearsightedness? Certainly not. Otherwise, how could he have not seen the real enemy, which he did, lurking by his side? So therefore, if the vandalizer thought that he could hurt our feelings by stealing the spectacles, he was dead wrong. And if he was a fan of the Mahatma, and he thought that he could steal these spectacles as part of his memorabilia, then in the true Gandhian spirit, we will forgive him. There will be occasion for all of us to hear more about the life and works of the Mahatma from the distinguished speakers who have gathered here today. But I would also convey, on behalf of the Government of India, that let us, on October 2 every year, observe silence for a minute for introspection as part of the observance of this day. And I would request you all, let us do this right now. Thank you.